the Ethiopian eunuch or court official of the Guinness, that is, the queen of the Ethiopians, who had come to Jerusalem to worship and was returning home. Seated in his chariot, he was reading the prophet Isaiah. The Spirit said to Philip, "Go and join up with that chariot." Philip ran up and heard him reading Isaiah the prophet and said, "Do you understand what you are reading?" He replied, "How can I unless someone instructs me?" So he invited Philip to get in and sit with him. This was the scripture passage he was reading. Like a sheep, he was led to the slaughter, and as a lamb before its shearer is silent, so he opened not his mouth. In his humiliation, justice was denied him. Who will tell of his posterity? For his life is taken from the earth. Then the eunuch said to Philip in reply, "I beg you, about whom is the prophet saying this? About himself or someone else?" Then Philip opened his mouth, and beginning with the scripture passage, he proclaimed Jesus to him. As they traveled along the road, they came to some water. And the eunuch said, "Look, there is water. What is to prevent my being baptized?" Then he ordered the chariot to stop. And Philip and the eunuch both went down into the water, and he baptized him. When they came out of the water, the Spirit of the Lord snatched Philip away, and the eunuch saw him no more, but continued on his rejoicing. Philip came to Azotus and went about proclaiming the good news to all the towns until he reached Caesarea. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Ordained a deacon. Come forward.
Present.
Reverend Father, Holy Mother Church asks you to ordain this man, our brother, to the responsibility of the diaconate.
Do you know him to be worthy?
After inquiry among the Christian people, and upon the recommendation of those responsible, I testify that he has been found worthy.
Relying on the help of the Lord God and our Savior Jesus Christ, we choose this man, our brother, for the order of the diaconate.
Thanks be to God.
To you, Mr. and Mrs. Hyde, and to your family, I offer heartfelt congratulations at the ordination of your son, of your brother, to the diaconate. At the same time, to Father Marcianda, the provincial superior, Father Leobardo, the prior of his house, and to Father Gergen, the student master, and to all of the Dominican community, my continued prayers for you that you may flourish as you strive to be faithful to your Holy Father Dominic. In a special way, we welcome Monsignor Pieper, who is the pastor of St. Clement of Rome Parish for 24 years. We're so glad that you could be here. And to all of you, greetings from Archbishop Carlson. And to you, Brother Patrick, to you begins the work. With the laying on of hands, that ancient symbol, setting you aside for divine things, you enter the clerical state as a deacon, with the mandate to serve others. In the not-too-distant future, God willing, that mandate will take on a greater focus with ordination to the priesthood. But for now, as a deacon, you are called to serve in the ministry of the word, of the altar, and of charity. And you will never lose that call to serve. Even as a priest, you will always be bound by the word, by the altar, and by charity, striving to be a servant of all. Most of you would not even notice, but underneath my chasuble, I wear the dalmatic, the vestment of a deacon, to symbolize that I, too, am still bound by the word, the altar, and charity. And now, as you become a deacon, you will take a public office in the church. In all that you do, you will never act alone, but rather by the bishop's directives and in obedience to your superiors. You will preside over public prayer, administer baptisms, assist in blessed marriages, bring viaticum to the dying, and help to bury the dead through our funeral rites. Your life is not your own. You are giving yourself over to service in the church. And in your service to the word, you must allow yourself to be formed by that word. Allow that word of God to convert your heart long before you open your mouth to preach a homily to the people of God. The people may or may not be moved by a well-crafted homily, but all will be touched by your life of holiness. And as we all know, the best homily is the way you live your life. Such a homily requires no words. It requires a sincere, transparent life centered on the Word of God. And don't underestimate the people of God. They can detect the phony. So be a hearer of the Word as well as a minister of the Word. In your service at the altar, you too must be a pleasing sacrifice unto the Father in union with Christ, long before you administer the body and blood of Christ to the people. In a couple of moments, you will lie prostrate on the floor as a symbol of your total gift of self to the church. May you be that true sacrifice, a total, unconditional sacrifice in union with Christ on the cross. Only in such a union will your chastity be spiritually fruitful. Anything less is to have a divided heart. And the public nature of the diaconate demands that your conduct be impeccable, above reproach. Compelled by the love of Christ, you must cling to him with an undivided heart. In your ministry of charity, serve the people of God with the very heart of Christ. Without charity, your chastity will grow cold, and your service at the altar will be sterile. The union of your heart with the heart of Christ, fueled in prayer, will become a beacon of light to draw others to Christ. It is essential that your heart be bonded to his divine heart. The people of God should not be drawn to you, but rather to Christ that they encounter in you. Charity, rooted in the word, and nourished at the altar. When that occurs, all will recognize in you a disciple of him who came not to be served, but to serve. At the beginning of this ordination ritual, the provincial testified that you were worthy, and we have to take his word on that. But now it's up to you to prove your worth. The church now gives you a mandate. By your entrance into the clerical state as a deacon, be that minister of the word that the church desires. Be always bound to the altar of sacrifice. Be on fire with divine charity. Now the work begins. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Before you enter the order of the diaconate, you must declare before the people your intention to undertake this office. Do you resolve to be consecrated to the church's ministry by the laying on of my hands and the gift of the Holy Spirit?
I do.
Do you resolve to discharge the office of deacon with humble charity in order to assist the priestly order and to benefit the Christian people?
I do.
You resolve to hold fast to the mystery of faith with a clear conscience, as the apostle urges, and to proclaim this faith in word and deed according to the gospel and the church's tradition.
I do.
You resolve to keep forever this commitment to remain celibate as a sign of your dedication to Christ the Lord for the sake of the kingdom of heaven in service of God and man.
I do.
You resolve to maintain and deepen a spirit of prayer that is proper to your way of life, and in keeping with this spirit and what is required of you, to celebrate faithfully the liturgy of the hours with and for the people of God, and indeed for the whole world.
I do.
Do you resolve to conform your way of life always to the example of Christ, of whose body and blood you are a minister at the altar?
I do, with God's help.
Do you promise respect and obedience to the diocesan bishop and to your legitimate superior?
I do.
May God, who's begun the good work in you, bring it to fulfillment. Will mercifully pour out the grace of his blessing on this his servant, of the Diaconate.
Let us kneel.
Lord, deliver.
Draw near, we pray, Almighty God, giver of every grace, who apportion every order and assign every office, who remain unchanged but make all things new. In your eternal providence, you make provisions for every age, as you order all creation through him who is your word, your power, and your wisdom, Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. You grant that the church, his body, adorned with manifold heavenly graces, drawn together in the diversity of its members, and united by a wondrous bond through the Holy Spirit, should grow and spread forth to build up a new temple. And as you once chose the sons of Levi to minister in the former tabernacle, so now you establish three ranks of ministers in their sacred offices to serve in your name. And so in the first days of your church, through the inspiration of the Holy Spirit, your sons apostles appointed seven men of good repute to assist them in the daily ministry, that they may devote themselves more fully to prayer and preaching of the word. By prayer and the laying on of hands, they entrusted to these chosen men the ministry of serving at table. We beseech you, Lord, look with favor on this servant of yours, who will minister at your holy altar, and whom we now humbly dedicate to the office of deacon. Send forth upon him, Lord, we pray, the Holy Spirit, that he may be strengthened by the gift of your sevenfold grace for the faithful carrying out of the work of this ministry. May there abound in him every gospel virtue, unfeigned love,
concern for the sick and poor, unassuming authority, the purity of innocence, and the observance of spiritual discipline. May your commandments shine forth in his conduct, so that by the example of his way of life, he may inspire the imitation of your holy people. In offering the witness of a clear conscience, may he remain strong and steadfast in Christ, so that by imitating on earth your Son, who came not to be served but to serve, he may be found worthy to reign in heaven with him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Thank you. shall see the God of gods in Zion. O Lord of hosts, hear my prayer, and look upon the face of your anointed.
Oh.
through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when the supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor
sinners commanded and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Lord, the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and ever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, to your servant, whom you have replenished with heavenly food and drink, that for the sake of your glory and the salvation of believers, they may be found faithful as ministers of the gospel, of the sacrament, and of charity, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Good morning.
Good morning.
For those of you who do not know me, my name is Leo, and I am the prior here. I would like to, first of all, thank Father Jimmy Marchanda for allowing me to welcome you and to give you some words of thanks. First of all, I would like to thank Bishop Edward Rice for accepting to be the ordaining bishop today. Your words were truly inspiring, and we pray that your minister is always your fault. Thank you for being with us today. Second, I would like to thank Patrick's family. We know that it has been a long and winding road, but we also know that this is a moment of joy, a moment of rejoicing, a moment of being proud of him, and of continue praying for him and for us. You know this, your family, but now more and more, we join with you in this joyful celebration. Congratulations. And thank you for allowing us to share with you, Patrick, in the service of God. Third, I would like to thank my Dominican brothers, friars and priests, all priests who have come to join us today. It is always a privilege to have all of you here to join us in this wonderful celebration. Thank you to Patrick's family and friends for being with us today. We're very happy to have you here. A special word of thanks to our Master of Ceremonies, Reverend Fonseca. Thank you to our assisting deacon, Reverend West. Thank you to the choir, ministers, to all those who helped us make this a wonderful celebration. And last but not least, our gratitude goes to our Reverend Deacon Patrick Hyde. Thank you for allowing us to have this wonderful celebration. Blessings, all the best. After this Eucharistic celebration, please join us for some refreshments.
May God, who founded the church and guides her still, protect you constantly with his grace, that you may faithfully discharge your duties forever and ever.
Amen.
May he who has entrusted deacons with preaching the gospel and of serving both altar and people, make you fervent witness of his gospel and a minister of his charity in the world forever and ever.
Amen.
May he make you who are priests, true shepherds, to provide living bread and word of life for the faithful, that they may continue to grow in the unity of the body of Christ forever and ever.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless all of you who are gathered here, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.